What is up, people? I have to do a couple little things because apparently there was an error fetching my stream information, which basically means the tags I use, such as multiplayer, playing with viewers, competitive. They don't even do roll anymore. I can't even do that. I used to do that. What else did I have? There was another one, too. Oh, PvP. I should do PvE if I play Anti-Mage, but all the same. We're here for the 7.25 patch. I think that's good enough. Anything else I have in there, it's not even that important. The tags aren't huge. If Thor, are you watching the stream right now, by the way?
I can.
Can you? And can you... I don't know if you can see the stream tags below, but it should say competitive multiplayer playing with viewers PvP. If it does, let me know.
Okay.
If it doesn't, it's not the end of the world. As long as it says Dota 2, I'm pretty happy. Under the game selected. So, gameplay update 7.25. It's rather large. They made changes to some system changes. They made changes to items. They made changes to heroes. It's gonna really change the way that Dota's played, not because of anything that's, like, different about the physical play. It's largely about the picking is the biggest change, I would say. So
right now, the thing says, Dota 2, Dota 2 7.25 review, English competitive multiplayer playing with viewers PvP MOBA.
Okay.
All that.
Cool. Thanks.
You're welcome. I'll be quiet now.
Thor will be here for the review. So, all pick hero picking has been reworked. Basically, now there are 5 rounds. Each round, Radiant Dire each pick a hero at the exact same time. And the selections each team makes is hidden until the next round, meaning that, like, if I have 25 seconds to pick or 30 seconds to pick the first hero, so I'm going to pick a 5 or 4 or whatever. If I pick in the first second, the other team doesn't get to see that. So there's no, like, waiting to the last second. Just pick. Like, it's fine. The other team won't see what I picked. I won't see what they picked. And then that will end. Now we go to the next pick. And now everybody's hero is revealed. So now it'll be like, oh, I picked Skywrath Mage. They picked Jakiro. Now everybody knows that. Now they pick the next hero together, simultaneously, so that nobody can see the other pick. And that way, as you pick up that ladder, no one knows exactly what the commensurate role will be, depending how you pick. Now, granted, you could pick weirdly. You could pick your first slot first or something. But as long as you decide to do a similar thing where you pick your 5, 4, 3, you know, 1, then 2, it'll be so that nobody knows what their opposite is on the enemy team until after they've picked. That'll stop a lot of the counterpicking that you see. Because realistically speaking, some heroes are bad because of counterpicks, and because of that, those heroes are now better, because it's harder to counter them. So, like, now if you're going to pick your 2, which I assume you're going to pick last, mid, you don't have to worry about getting countered. They have to preemptively counter you by picking a hero that might counter the hero you're thinking about playing without even knowing you're playing it, which makes it less likely they counter that particular pick. And now nobody has to be that crappy spot where they're the 9th of 10 picks and be like, ugh, the enemy mid will know what I'm picking. You know, and I don't know what he's gonna pick, so I'm screwed. There's no more of that. If you end up picking the same hero, which can happen, the player who picked it second, which means the one who is less sure about their pick, will be given some extra time to select another hero, showing them, like, yes, you can't play this hero, try again. Reworked how hero banning works. Before, you would pick however many heroes you want to ban, up to 10, and then it would choose half of them. Now, each individual hero has a 50% chance of succeeding when you choose it. What's up, Fairy Tale for Life? Welcome. The reason this matters is if I decided to ban, I'm gonna spoil Ursa, who's now broken. If I want to ban Ursa, before if I want to ban Ursa, I'm the first person to ban. I say I want to ban Ursa. Sure. Now everybody else has the incentive to also ban heroes. However, each hero that was put up for banning would reduce the chance that Ursa's banned. Because when you have 2 heroes up for banning, 50-50. 3 heroes is a 33%, technically. 4 heroes is back to 50-50. But depending if it's odd or even and how many there are, it will decrease the chances that Ursa in particular gets banned. Now, it's a solid 50 flat. And on top of that, if you have less than 10 heroes banned, meaning not everybody chooses a hero, they'll automatically roll for banning based on their ban rate at our bracket. So in my bracket, if Ursa's banned all the time but no one decides to ban him, he might just get banned. Power runes now spawn at 4 minutes instead of 2, and they do spawn every 2 still, so it'll be the same after that, but that first spawn doesn't happen. I think it's that people can focus on the laning to start, and they don't have to worry about getting that first rune before bottles are even bought, before it's relevant, that kind of thing. It doesn't really matter that much. I like it, but I don't play mid. Power runes no longer spawn on both sides of the map at 40 minutes. This is because it was too strong to get a DD and a haste and then start a fight. It was too strong. Or an invis in a DD. That too. Remove the team-based rubber band mechanics for hero kills. Basically, I'm not going to read to you the way it changed, but more or less there were rubber band mechanics based on where your net worth was and the hero that you killed. And if you were behind, it would be more generous to you if your team was behind. Now there's still an increase in the gold if you were behind them, but not if your team was behind. So before, if you were the one position having the most money on your team, but your team is losing, you'd get a bunch of gold for killing an enemy hero. Now it's realistically just based on the net worth you have and the hero you killed. Making the losing team, the core has less incentive to kill supports because he's not going to get that much. This is an example. It also means that if the enemy team gets a team wipe, they get less gold overall because there's no more team-based. It's just the singular hero's killing. So it's going to be a lot less money flooding in, to my understanding. I'm not going to do the math. It's crazy. It's nuts. However, sprees matter a lot more. The bounty for killing a spree for gold has gone up. The minimum is much lower and the maximum is much higher. And the same thing with the XP for that. Minimum's higher and the max is higher for both, I mean. So you're just going to get a lot more XP and a lot more gold for taking a spree for someone, meaning it's very difficult to be a mid who's ahead and then die. Dying is a lot more important in that regard. Captain's mode now has band counts per phase, changed from 3-2-1 to 4-1-1, meaning you have one more front-loaded band. It's the same number of bands total, but it means that you can get one more hero out of there before any picks, basically. Random draft hero pool was reduced by 10. That's just nice. I would actually say it sucks if you have too many heroes, but it's a greater chance of omitting heroes you don't want to see too, so it's kind of a mixed bag. Radiant Ancient Creeps are now easier to stack. I don't know which camps, but that's just nice. It's a buff to Radiant, which they probably didn't need, but still. It's annoying when you can't stack properly. Tier 1 neutral item drop rate was increased by 4. This is because the Tier 1 items, their drop rate, which isn't high enough, considering that you don't have that long before Tier 2's drop. So it increases the chance that you can get all of the Tier 1 items that you're supposed to get before Tier 2 items are available, basically. And this is also multiplied since Ancients give a multiplication of the regular drop rate, so you're very much likely to get Tier 1 items from Ancients. Fountain attack damage went up again. I love this because I hate fountain diving, so it's even harder to fountain dive. Not impossible, but it's hard. Neutral creep ice armor slow was reduced, and the ice armor it gives is also reduced, meaning it's just worse. The reason why is it's too strong. It gives way too much armor, and the attack the slow on it when you hit the armor is too much. Illusion rune now has similar mechanics to Manta. It shuffles you, dispels you, and dodges, meaning it disjoints. It's super strong. Now having illusion rune in a bottle is very valuable because if someone tries to cast a spell at you that is disjointable, you can disjoint it. You know, you're technically invulnerable for like a millisecond, and it also makes it hard to know which one's you. Faded Brooch mana was reduced by 25 because it gives too much mana pool. This hurts OD too, which is nice. Iron Talon now works in Ancients. That's a huge buff to Iron Talon. It's actually okay now. I still don't love it just because I hate the active and keeping track of it, but that's on me. That doesn't mean people who do keep track of it, you know, it's the same. They'll actually benefit a lot. Because the 50% of its current health, that's huge against the big Ancient, the boss of each camp, that's huge. Poor Man's Shield, agility increased by 1. Nice. I love Poor Man's Shield, so I'm behind that. Philosopher's Stone gold income is plus 10. That's huge for the 5 or the 4. Getting that money is going to be very big for them. Because 10 more gold per minute, right? Yeah. No, yeah, but per minute. It adds up. You know what I mean? It's not huge, but it adds up. Grove Bow gives it 5 more attack speed. That's nice. Magic Resistance from Nethershawl went up. A lot of these earlier items just got buffed. Spiderlip's turn rate. Spiderlip's turn rate is actually obnoxious. It's crazy. And the passive move speed is higher too. I can't even believe what they're doing with it. Honestly, it's nuts. It's way too fast. Repair kit self-regen increased by 3. I don't think that's going to be a huge deal. It's nice to carry it around and get some bonus HP regen, but it's not that big of a deal. A lot of supports are carrying Tranquils anyway. Enchanted Quiver, the cooldown went by 2, down by 2, which is actually pretty big. That's notable. Havoc Hammer, the knockback area was increased by 50, making it better on those strength heroes. You need to like get heroes just de-initiated from your core, or a core who wants that. The slow now also affects speed, meaning that they get 50% slow and a 50% 50 attack slow, because it's never percentage with attack slow, which is actually notable. So that's nice, actually. Havoc Hammer's pretty good now, because you can really disrupt a core with this if they don't have BKB. Flicker. Cooldown went down, but the range was reduced. The active is pretty crap, to be honest with you. It's whatever. I can't really see it being that useful with having the range reduced. You're not going to go anywhere. The leveler attack speed increased by 10, making it one of the best tier 4 items. It's crazy, the number amount of attack speed you get from this. Spell immunity on Minotaur Horn went up by 0.25. That's minor, but it does matter. You know, it ends up being big for certain heroes, basically. Witless Shaco got its health increased by 200. I think that definitely matters for some heroes. I think 200 isn't a lot in the late game when you're getting these tier 4 items, but it's nice. I mean, I'm sure those supports who are going to pick it up, or the threes they're going to pick it up, it's going to be a big deal. Seer Stone now has 10 mana regen, which is really cool since, you know, it's supposed to be a casting-like item, so it's nice to have it have some other benefit. Ballista's knockback pure damage was increased by 10, making it obnoxious because the pure damage is just stupid. Because its knockback is guaranteed. It's not proc-based. So, you know, every hit does 40 pure damage. So if Sniper gets this, you just lose the game, basically. I can't see any other answer. Right, Thor?
What's up?
Ballista being broken now.
Oh.
It's a guaranteed... Yeah, guaranteed 40 pure damage per hit.
Yeah. That's gonna be fun. Hey, who wants to die horribly to friggin', like, I don't know, Medusa, or... Sniper or anything else.
Woodland Strider's health regen increased by 10. That's minor, but it's nice. I mean, it doesn't get deactivated when you get hit like Tranquils, so I'll take it as a cool thing for some heroes. TP has got a big change because of these combined things. Cost increased by 40. Ooh, that's so expensive. I hate them. So upset as a core because I don't have that money to spend. I know I do, but I don't. Supports are going to have a harder time too now because they're supposed to rotate more, so that's a big deal. Travels, no longer have an active. Thank you for that, because I hate having more items to hit. It now upgrades your town portal while equipped. So you have travels, they go in your inventory. Now your town portal scroll is upgraded. It reduces the cooldown to 40, which is nice, because it's great. It allows it to target units, and does not consume a charge on usage. Movement speed on travels was also upped by 6 and 9 commensurately. The reason why this matters, the movement speed obviously just matters, but the reason why this matters is before, let's just say, Ember Spirit travels into a fight. He fights for about 30 seconds, things go a little poorly. He remnants into the trees, and he town portal scrolls back to base. Nope, not anymore. You get 1 TP. It is the combined. Now granted, the cooldown is 40 seconds. However, that's all you get. So if Ember Spirit comes in with his upgraded town portal scroll because he has travels, he has no way out besides leaving an Ember remnant in base. And as we all know, that means he can't initiate with that Ember or burst damage with Ember because he can't, otherwise he loses the one at base, leaving him in a very precarious spot. Now, granted, I don't think it's going to really hurt Ember Spirit that much, but it's an example of one of those annoying things you could do to be all over the map at once, and they're cutting it, which is nice. Javelin, damage reduced by 80 because of the proc damage. Because it's too much. This hurts Windranger. This hurts Pengo too, because he often procs the Javelin. I like this a lot. I think the Javelin shouldn't do that much damage. I hate it. So I'm really happy about this. Mjolnir attack speed was reduced by 10. This is a dramatic nerf. A lot of heroes rush Mjolnir, but now that you lose 10 attack speed, I'm not sure if it's going to be right on all heroes. It's still good, but man, that's a big hit. 10 attack speed matters. Orb of Venom does less damage. The slow was increased, but for less time, meaning you have to consistently hit them. This makes it a lot worse on ranged heroes, because now that the slow doesn't last, even though the slow was worse on ranged heroes, of course, it's only 4%, but it lasts less time, meaning that, you know, you're not even going to get a slow, basically, and it's not going to last any bit, and you're not going to do any damage with it, making Orb of Venom really terrible for ranged heroes. You're only going to see it on melee heroes, and even then, it's only if they're going to get a kill. Because this slow isn't going to matter unless you can kill, since the duration isn't long. So if they have a stun, it's worthless. Ring of Regen is cheaper. Headdress no longer requires an Iron Branch, making it cheaper. This is a lot of things don't require Iron Branch anymore. It no longer provides 3-to-all stats, but the HP regen went up. The reason why this matters is it's less of a good item to buy on everybody in lane. It still does the HP aura, and it's better, meaning I know some heroes are going to buy it anyway. But without the stats, that's a painful trait. It is cheaper, but that's a painful trait. Sage's Mask. Mana regen went up. Cost was reduced by 25. Ring of Basilius no longer provides an Iron Branch, but lost its stats. It gives more mana now. Mostly because this gives more mana. So, I think that a value Ring of Basilius on some heroes like Bristle is still fine because he really wants it for the mana, which got buffed. But no stats really stinks. Really stinks. Buckler, no Iron Branch. No 3 stats. Recipe cost went down by 75. Armor went up, which is nice. Again, I can see like a niche hero picking up one of these items, like Headdress, Basilius, or Buckler, but it's not going to be everybody, which is exactly what I'm happy about. I hated this being the meta, so I'm glad to see it's like scaling back more into niche. Vlad's all stats. They lost 1 to all stats, but the mana regen went up, making it worse for cores, honestly. I probably wouldn't buy it on any cores anymore, to be honest with you. I'm done with Vlad's. It's been nerfed too many times. I know it's minor this time, but it adds up. Veil mana regen went up. They really want us to have more mana regen now, I think. They don't want us to be faring clarities in as much. Not that you can't. You still can. But I think they want to universally just give more mana. Speaking of clarities, that'll come up too. Bloodthorn. Now requires a Hyperstone instead of Crystallis. Crystallis was a 2150 item, while Hyperstone is 2000, making Bloodthorn a little cheaper. The attack damage went down dramatically. And the attack speed went up because of the Hyperstone. No longer has a passive crit chance. This makes Bloodthorn a much worse item. It's nice to have a high attack speed because attack speed versus damage, attack speed actually is better in the late game for almost all cores because your passive stats will give you enough damage where attack speed is more valuable. However, not having the passive crit's huge. That's such a big nerf. I can definitely see it on some heroes, but you're not going to see it nearly as much. It's a big nerf. Battle Fury now requires Broadsword and Mithril Hammer. Note that Broadsword down here costs 1,000, so 1,000 and 1,600 is 2,800. Sorry, 2,600. 1,000 plus 1,600, 2,600. Which normally would be less than the Demon Edge, which is 24. However, the recipe is gone, which was 300. I know Battle Fury in and out because, of course, I used to buy it all the time. Still will. So, compare the price before. Now it is 2,600 versus 24 plus 3, which is 27. Battle Fury is 100 gold cheaper with no negative. In fact, there's a positive because now you don't need the Secret Shop because you don't need the Demon Edge. And you buy it in parts. So you don't need 2,400 lump sum. You need 1,000 and 1,600. Big deal. Damage was reduced on Broadsword by 2, making it a worse item to carry around with you. But honestly, that's fine. Crystallis, recipe cost increased. It's 200 more expensive. Already a worse item. Damage was reduced by 9. Yeah, I thought it was 9. I don't know why I had a problem with that. No, it's 11. I'm sorry. Yeah, 11. Damage reduced by 11. And the crit strike chance was increased by 10, which is nice, but not worth it. Crystallis is a worse item. You will not see it on everybody now. That's a big nerf. No recipe for Vanguard. However, they added a recipe to... Well, they added the 200 back-ended on Crimson, but also added it back-ended on Abyssal. Meaning that both things that Vanguard builds into cost 200 more. So when you upgrade it, you'll end up paying the cost that you saved back. So it'll be the same. But just to buy the value Vanguard is cheaper, which is nice. Some heroes like to buy a Vanguard. It's not too expensive. Eagle Song is 200 cheaper. Thank you. It's been too expensive for too long. However, they did nerf it by 5 agility, making that very... The Butterfly by 5 agility, which is very sad. Butterfly's very good. That's probably why they did it. It's kind of making items like Scotty look a little bit better comparatively, which is, again, sad. E-Blade, its primary attribute damage was reduced by 50, but the base blast damage went up by 50. So here's where that matters. If you did one had 100 agility, 50% of your agility would be 50 damage. So, at 100 agility or less, I'm just saying agility because that's the hero we're about to refer to, which is Morphling, as you know. If you have 100 of your primary stat or less, E-Blade actually does more damage now. As soon as you pass the threshold of 100, E-Blade does... Sorry, E-Blade does more damage if you have less than 100 primary stat. E-Blade does less now if you have more than 100, because now you start losing that efficiency from percentage. So for Morphling, who will have like 200 and something agility, huge nerf to the shotgun build. Huge. I mean, not huge, but pretty big. So I'm very happy about this. Basically, the Kaya component of these two bigger items just got better. The mana loss and the spell amp. It's the same on both. It's not a big deal. It's just nice. Nullifier. No longer mutes enemies. item's already trashed. Throw it out. Now, mute is a very, very controlled thing. There's only like three things that can do it, and none of them are items. Now, continuously dispels the target over its duration. Its duration was reduced to 5. The reason you'd want to continuously dispel is... Sorry, I got a text. So, the reason why you would want that is if someone has, like, buffs coming on them consistently, like their team, like a lot of buffs, self-buffs, whatever. I can't even imagine what they would be, but, like, I'm trying to think. Like, Ogre Magi is trying to buff them and stuff. The continual dispel means you don't have to time it. You just throw an all-fire on them, and they can't be buffed during the duration because it'll repurge it. The slow was reduced in percentage, but went on for just 0.1 seconds. That's a worse slow, though. Cooldown was reduced by 2, which is nice. Cast range got increased. Armor increased. Damage increased. Honestly, the item's just worse. I don't think people are going to pick it up at all, to be completely real with you. I just don't see it. I don't see any case where someone's going to say, yeah, Nullifier is going to be the item, you know? One of my coworkers was just saying she's filing for unemployment while we're out of work, since we can't go back to our jobs. But I don't think it'll be long enough to be worth it. Personally, I don't really want to file for like a week of pay or 2 weeks of pay. If it's a lot longer, then that'd be a different story. But I don't know. That's a hard one. Force staff cast range was reduced by 200 on allies. No longer undispellable. Meaning that I guess while you're being pushed, you could be dispelled and stop pushing. Very interesting. What's up, Cheese Jam? How you doing, my friends? It's been a while. It's been a long time. Keep getting the same person texting me. It's kind of important. Hurricane Pike, same thing. It was reduced by 250 instead of 200. For the cast range on allies, no longer undispellable as well. So the reason this matters is if someone's getting pushed, you could actually stop them, I believe. Which is crazy when you think about it. You can cast like a purge and it would stop them from being pushed, making force staff a less reliable ability to get your ally out. But also on top of that, the range means you have to be a lot closer. So a support trying to save his core is probably going to die. Glimmer Cape, cast range was reduced by 250. Same thing. You were probably going to die saving your core, basically. Which is awesome. That's the way it should be. Vision reduced on observer wards by 200, making it much harder to cover like the jungle. I don't know. I really do like it. Harder to see people coming. It's just iffy. Observer wards aren't bought enough as it is, even though they're free. I don't know. It's interesting to say this. It's not. It's gonna make it a lot harder to see where people are moving around, making it easier to like kind of like move around the map. Holy Locket recipe was reduced by 300, making it a little bit better, but still I don't see this being bought on almost anybody. Necro gives less gold and XP bounties, which is awesome, making it much less risky to have, and the recipe cost went down by 50. Cool. It's a minor buff, but I'll take it. Aeon Disc cooldown, I just decided to invite you because why not? Cooldown went down by 10. On Aeon Disc, making it a much better item, actually. I'm more okay with this being bought on multiple people. The cheaper or better the cooldown gets, the more I'm okay with other people buying this, basically. This is, like, really cool, actually. Silver Edge now reduces regen, and I should probably keep this at the bottom. Now reduces regen and heals by 50%. This means it's actually a counter to Alchemist, which is cool. Anybody who heals a lot, Timbersaw, it's twice as good because it shuts off him being able to gain charges of his reactive armor, but also reduces the heal of currently existing charges. Big deal. Clarities, here it comes. The duration went down by 20, even though the regen went up by 1.5. Overall value went down because it used to be 50 times 4 is 200, half is 25, so it used to be 225. Now it's 180. So we lost 45 mana from Clarities. However, at least it happens faster, meaning getting it canceled isn't as big of a deal. So that's good. Infused Raindrops mana was increased, which is really nice. This is a good item. I don't see it bought enough. I never buy it because I'm stupid. I should. Bottle's 25 cheaper, which is awesome. It should be. It's too expensive right now. It used to be. I remember when it used to be like 5-something, so crazy. Medallion mana, regen increase, Solar Crest, same thing. Here we go. Ring of Health. Health regen went up by 0.5. Cost reduced by 25. Voidstone cost reduced by 25. You know what builds out of Ring of Health and Voidstone? Go ahead, Thor. What builds out of Ring of Health and Voidstone?
Crap, don't remember off the top of my head.
They go together to equal a Perseverance. You know what Perseverance builds into?
Battle Fury?
Battle Fury! So Battle Fury is 100 from before and 50 cheaper. Battle Fury. And you know who buys Battle Fury?
Anti-Mage.
Anti-Mage! I'm so excited. And I know everybody's thinking in their head, surely Anti-Mage nerfs are coming. Not today. Oh, and Perseverance's health regen went up by 0.5 as well.
Well, that's barely worth mentioning to you.
It is, because usually it depends how you build it, but oftentimes I get the full Perseverance as the last part of my Battle Fury, or a very minimal time. It's nice, but it's not, like, huge.
No, I just meant, like, how, like, you had to think, oh, yeah, but... like,
I had to scroll
down. Everything else was exciting. That was just like, meh.
Hood of Defiance health regen went up. Pipe health regen went up. No longer provides stats at all. That really hurts pipe carriers. You're going to want to see this in a lot more fours. Mana cost for a Lotus Orb went up. Very painful for mana starved heroes who buy Lotus. That means Pudge. I won't spoil, but Pudge is ruined, but this hurts a lot. Timber Saw usually has good mana, so he'd be fine, but it really does depend on the hero. Helm of Iron Will regen went up, but the cost went up by 25, which is very painful. Ring of Tarrasque cost was reduced. Health regen increased. Anything that builds out of Ring of Tarrasque, which is Heart, is buffed commensurately, of course, because it's cheaper, which is very nice, actually. Heart now, comparatively, is getting a little bit better, because 100 gold off, it really does add up. It's nice. Tranquils heal us. I actually didn't catch this the first time I walked through. I guess I missed this one. This is a big deal. 2 less health regen. Oh, it's so good. Screw Tranquils. Abaddon, and we're into the heroes. They just buffed his Mist Coil AoE. It's really nice, but it's not a big deal. Alchemist got an agility gain buff. That's very nice, because he'll attack a little faster, get a little armor. I don't think it's going to change the hero. Arc Warden moves 5 faster. That is a big deal. It's harder to catch Arc Warden now. He's very slow, but being less slow can be the difference between dying and not dying. So that's very annoying to me. It also means he can push better. Bat Rider. Firefly movement speed was reduced at all levels. Thank you very much. Flame Break impact damage was also reduced. Thank you very much. Beast Rider. Beastmaster's base attack speed was increased by 10. I don't think necessarily he needed this. He's already a pretty strong hero at the higher brackets, but it's nice. Wild Axe's damage type was changed from physical to magical, making it much less likely for people to take a lot of damage, because you see a lot of magic resistance and value, like cloaks and early hoods and stuff. The debuff duration is increased from 10 to 12, and it no longer pierces spell immunity at all. Big nerf on that part. I actually think maybe changing to magical is a nerf, just because the heroes... Well, it's a nerf and a buff at the same time. It's a nerf against some heroes who are likely to have magic resistance stacked, but it's a buff against high armor heroes, because before your axes did nothing, and now they'll actually do a little bit more damage. So it's kind of a weird situation. I definitely think the no longer piercing spell immunity is dramatic, though. Bloodseeker got his heal nerfed. It's minor. Bounty, I hate him. Rework Scepter. Now applies Janata to Shuriken Toss. Increases cast range to 650 and lowers cooldown to 6. So Shuriken's up all the time. It casts very far. It can still bounce. Track and with the Axe and stuff. It does not do a crit, is what Cool said. So the Janata doesn't mean that it crits. It just steals a bunch of gold. So Bounty Hunter will now throw a Shuriken that will hit half the team and steal gold from all of them simultaneously. I hate it. Also, Shuriken Toss costs less early, so awesome. They also changed his attack speed to be later, which is nice because he's online later, but it's higher, and Shuriken Toss was thrown down to be... thrown earlier to be a little weaker. I hate him. Brewmaster, the fire brewling does more damage by a little bit. Its interval, its immolation's better. They changed his health talent. They buffed his health talent and buffed the cooldown talent. The cooldown now goes down to 50? No, sorry, I was looking at the wrong number. 45. Now it's a 45 cooldown because it's 120, 75, so 45. The cooldown will be 45 once he takes the talent, and it lasts for 20. So it'll be down for 25 seconds. It's not terrible. It's a nice buff. He needed it. Brewmother just got a little buff. Chaos Knight, big deal. Phantasm cooldown was reduced as you level. Very big deal. Because that's 20 seconds off cooldown, already good enough. On top of the fact that with the cooldown reduction talent that he has, and the increased duration that he has as a talent, he can be relevant more often in the match, which is the big problem with Chaos Knight. When he has no ult, he's not a hero. Reality Rift also casts from farther, making it much better to get kills with. Clink's death pack no longer has a neutral level requirement, meaning that he can eat any neutral first level death pack for the rest of the game. So he can actually eat the large camp creeps and gain money through his lane, basically. Burning Arm, you got a slight increase in damage. It's minor, but it's nice because Clink can actually get ahead now. That's how he wins. He has to be above, ahead of you. If he doesn't have money, he doesn't win the game. Freezing Field Scepter Frostbite timer was reduced. I think what that means is when you're in the Freezing Field, Frostbite will happen sooner. Is that what that means? Yes, that's what it means. I see it now. So it's actually better to have Ags on her. It's okay. I like it. It's easier to combo into. Darkseer Surge movement speed was changed from a percentage to a flat amount. The flat amount is really high, granted, but it means as the game goes on, it's worse because it doesn't scale. And they ruin the cooldown early, making it harder for him to lane safely. They also changed his damage to Iron Shell Radius, which no one cares about the Iron Shell Radius. So a lot of nerfs to Darkseer. Dazzle, he's a meme now. When you cast an ability, you automatically launch an attack on 8 enemies. Higher than your attack range, mind you. I don't even know what to do anymore. I don't want to see this. He's going to buy like a Daedalus and just do that. They also, they did nerf his damage talent though. So that's nice. Excuse me, sorry. I had a weird burp there. Death Prophet. Exorcism now provides a 20% movement speed increase. Kill me now, honestly. I can't even believe this. I can't even believe this. Right now, because I think I forgot. I did forget. Right now, let's add Death Prophet to the ban list. We're doing it in real time. I cannot stand Death Prophet. Dragonite's a little faster. He needed it. He's too slow. Drow's attack animation's improved. A lot of heroes got this. It just means that they're going to be able to attack a little bit faster and attack cancel, meaning attack and like back up real quick. Because you can actually like move around heroes when you do that. You can attack and move before your attack's ready anyway. A lot of people don't know that. But if you attack and then immediately move a step, then attack again, you actually do not lose efficiency and attack speed. Unless your attack speed's very high. Like, very high. Like, agility carry, level 25 high. So, it makes it easier when your attack animation gets fixed on either end, either the attack point or the backswing. Because you can actually walk around a little bit more and get ready to attack again. You can follow people. Agility gain increased by 0.9 on Earth Spirit. It's nice. He gets some armor. He got buff on all of his talents, basically. Pretty big one, too, on the spell amp. Earth Spirit's coming back in. I mean, he's always been a good hero, but he's really coming back hard. Elder Titan just got some nice little buffs. None of them are dramatic. Ember Spirit Searing Chains is better earlier as far as cooldown's concerned, and their mana cost scales up to where it's supposed to be, meaning it's actually much cheaper, too. Making a level 1 Searing Chains a very good ability. His talent for Flame Guard Absorb also went up, meaning that against heavy magic nukes, he'll have like a really crazy amount of Flame Guard Absorb. Sproink, the distance went up. I can't even believe how far away she jumps. It's so stupid. Enigma, base int increased by 3. That's really nice for Enigma. It means that he gets more damage when he's farming if he decides to go jungle or lane or push. Black Hole went up by 50 at all levels, meaning he has a much better teamfight presence, which is already crazy. Malphus' damage on 15 goes up by a tremendous amount. He's getting to be a really good hero, actually. I like Enigma. Grimstroke. The Rend from Phantom's Embrace went up pretty notably at earlier levels, making the good early kill tool, to be honest with you. He got a buffs to both of his talents. I really like the Spell Imp one. That's pretty big. Gyrocopter is the new Medusa. Attack backswing was reduced, making it easier for him to walk around as he's attacking, like I said. Strength gain was increased. He's a little tankier. Flak Cannon did get nerfed by how many instances you get. However, the cooldown got halved. And the duration may have gone down, but who cares? You attack so fast, it doesn't really matter. The second missile and call down does more damage by a tremendous amount. The cooldown did get increased, which is fine. Nobody cares. And the talent to decrease its duration got doubled, which doesn't equal out the increase. So that's unfortunate. But so his ult's up less often, but everything else about him is just better. He is so good now. Huskar gets lower max attack speed from being low health, meaning he's just a worse hero. Juggernaut got a new scepter upgrade! Swift Slash. I'm so excited. I've already tried this in the bot game. It's fun. You perform a mini Omni Slash. It looks identical. No way to tell the difference. It lasts 0.8 seconds, which is low. Cast range is 650. Cooldown is 15. Meaning that you can spam it a little bit in fights. So what I've been doing, just testing it like in a bot game, is I open with Swift Slash. You can spin if you want to. Then ult, and then Swift Slash is almost ready again when you come out. Now, granted, that'll depend on the disables. You might want to save spin for after your actual Omni or whatever, so you can back out for a minute and come back in with Swift Slash, but it's actually really cool. You can farm with it too, in theory, because it still gives you the bonus damage and stuff that your ult normally would, so it's actually like really good. It makes you invulnerable, so I believe it purges you. I couldn't test that out, but I'm pretty sure it purges you too. So it's actually like a really good ability. Coddle, a lot of changes to talents. No one cares about spell apps. They got rid of it. Blinding Light, much better. Much better. Will-O-Wisp health count got put way up. Instead, they changed the flicker to have earlier flickers. I don't think the flickers matter that much. But if they're going to matter, they're much more important earlier. Flickers later don't matter. It'll die before it gets that many flickers. Instead of magic resistance, which I didn't really like a lot, they changed the Will-O-Wisp AoE, which is gigantic. A huge Will-O-Wisp. Gigantic. I love it. And instead of the flicker at the later level, it does the health count, which is minor, to be honest. I don't think either of these really matter that much, but it's nice to see the earlier talents. Kunkka gets more armor. And Cleave, shoot me now. I hate his talents. Legion's overwhelming odds talent is better now per hero, which is nice. She's better at clearing illusions now, since that universal damage she'll be hitting the team with will be higher per hero as it stacks. Meaning that all the illusions are dead. Leshrac, agility gain increased by 0.5. Better backswing on attack. Pulse Nova activation cost was reduced, making it easier for him to cast. Nice buffs. Leshrac will be played. Attack point reduced on Luna. Attack backswing reduced. Sorry, Lina. Making her just better at attacking. Huge for her. Huge for her. Instead of going like this. Now she just kind of goes, I haven't seen it, but she should be like this. Just like attacking. My hand was a little off screen there, but she should just like throw it, which is the point. Lone Druid, instead of 125 attack range, which was minimal, the Spirit Bear moves much faster, which is crazy because people are building on the bear now anyway. So the bear is inescapable. Luna, base strength by 3, which is 60 health, base and some magic resistance. Int increased by 5, that's a lot of mana, and spell amp. Agility gain decreased by 0.2, though. So her right-clicking is worse. But in general, she's more survivable. Lycan, Feral Impulse Health Regen went up by 1 at all levels. Ow. Shapeshift Duration increased by 4. That's a dramatic buff. That's huge. Because he uses this to escape, but he also uses this to fight. So that's very painful. Magma's Shockwave Slow was increased by 0.15. 0.15. I mean, whatever. Health talent went up. Shockwave damage went up. Who cares? Mars, his God Rebuke Scepter, now always lowers the cooldown rather than just during Arena of Blood, making it a much better Ags. And the Scepter cooldown was from 1.4 to 3.5. So now it's not like unreasonable where you spam it. But it's pretty fast. And it's all the time, so it's nice. Mars will be played again, I think. I still see him at higher level MMR because of Arena of Blood. But other than that, I think I'll see him at all levels more. Medusa, Mystic Snake gain went up dramatically. I might actually take this talent now. I love the attack speed, but that's questionable. Mirana, base damage increased by 2, making her much better. Sacred Arrow damage increased by 20 at first level, scaling all the way up to 50 at late levels. Well, it's... Yeah, at the max, I mean. Which is... No, it's the base damage. I'm sorry. Yeah. It's just the damage. That's pretty big. I like that a lot. She's much better now. I might play her more. Is she actually on my hero list? Yep. Nature's Prophet, the first of two broken heroes. Attack backswing reduced, making Prophet just better at right-clicking. Thanks. That would already have been enough to make me cry. Wrath of Nature cooldown was increased. Thank you, he doesn't push as much without being there. However, now when he kills creeps with Wrath of Nature, he gets damage for 50 seconds. And this damage is going to mean Nature's Prophet can push harder the lane he wants to push or fight. So kill me now.
Nightstalker.
Base health regen. Movement speed. Which is nice because he multiplies that when he does his Hunter in the Night. His lifesteal talent went up. Dark Ascension cooldown talent went down, which is good, meaning like it's a bigger reduction. Nice. It's a nice place for Nightstalker to be in. I think he's in a great place now. Ogre lost an armor. Unplayable. No, I'm just kidding. It's just worse, though. It stinks to be that, to lose an armor. Phoenix base health regen increased by 0.5, which is dramatic for Phoenix. Base damage increased by 2, making him actually able to last it without Fire Spirits. Puck lost 2 damage. Pudge, here we go. 1 base health regen increase. Hooray! Flesh Sheep now provides magic resistance. Hooray! Instead of health regen. I don't see how you lane as this hero. Anywhere. Literally anywhere. I don't see how you can play Pudge. You'll just die. Like, I don't get it. I hope they change it because it's unplayable, in my opinion. I don't see any lane where he can be valuable at all. Pugna, Nether Ward mana drain rescaled. Almost done. We're only a little bit late too, Thor. We're doing good. Nether Ward mana drain was rescaled to do earlier mana drain, which is nice. Life drain damage was reduced. Nice, but the cooldown was reduced dramatically, making him life drain all the time. The scepter now also increases damage tremendously. It's so much damage. And the break distance was, however, reduced, meaning it's harder for him to keep life drain on you. So it's good and bad, good and bad. Quap. Shadow Strike slow was increased at late levels pretty notably. Sad. And Sonic Wave cooldown was reduced by 10, meaning she can ult more often. Ouch. Murky got a little damage nerf on his talent. Fade Bolt mana cost was increased, making Rubick a little bit harder to manage in the early game. Sand King, he got love! Caustic Finale slow duration increased from 3 up to 4.5 when it scales, which is awesome. And it now reduces attack speed as well. That's the big deal. Because it does a... Attack speed is 15 up to 30. That's pretty dramatic. Sand King is a big deal against cores. Epicenter now does more damage as you level, meaning that he'll kill supports even easier now. Demonic Purge damage was increased by 50 at all levels, which is nice. It's cool, I guess. Silencer. Intelligence Steel is now part of Glaives of Wisdom instead of being innate, which ruins him in Ability Draft, not that I care. It also means he has to level Glaives. He doesn't get into otherwise. You have to take Glaives if you think you're going to get a kill. The end. His talent for Arcane Slow went up because it's not that good. Most people, I think, must take the 2 permanent Intelligence Steel, so, you know. Slark's Pounce Scepter distance was reduced by 100 again, making it worse. It's still good, but it hurts. Sapphire has an Aghanims, as does Void Spirit. So everybody has an Aghs now. Gobble up. Mortimer swallows an ally, creep, or hero, and spits them towards enemies, stunning enemies in the area for 1.5 seconds, and leaving a glob that does 100 DPS for 3 seconds. Unit can stay in his belly for 3 seconds. Cooldown is 40 seconds. Cast range is not high at all. He has to be basically point blank, being Mortimer, you know, with Sapphire. I don't think it's broken, but I think in certain AoE stun comps, like with a Magnus or a Centaur, this is better.
It's also kind of funny because if apparently somebody did a test on it, I saw it. Batrider can lasso somebody. You can eat the Batrider and chuck them under tower with it, and they'll drag the person along.
Well, you have to have a target, though. You have to target an enemy, it says.
No, I'm saying if you have a Batrider on your team, they lasso an enemy, you can eat the Batrider, spit him out, and his lasso will drag the enemy.
Right, but you have to have a target under tower to spit at.
Do you?
It says... Maybe it's wrong, but it says and spit it towards enemies. Maybe it just meant in general. I hope it does. It's way better that way, but either way. Scatterbass cooldown was nerfed. Sniper got a base damage increase of 4. Welcome, heralds, to the age of the sniper. Headshot damage was reduced by 10, which is fine because base damage is way better anyway. Assassinate Scepter cast time was reduced to half, meaning that with an Ags, he just boom. Spectre got a base health buff of 1, making her much better at lane. Shadow Step, which is her Aghanims, got a 35 second cooldown buff. Pretty big. It's pretty big. Reworked Scepter on Spirit Breaker. Charge Doctor's movement speed by 100 and reduces cooldown by 5. Pretty big. Storm Spirit base attack speed went up by 10. Sven got a movement speed buff, which is pretty big, actually. Techies, 25 mines, movement speed wasn't enough. Let's triple it, 75. I guarantee we see some funny games where Techies just stacks mines at 25 in the trees, and they move quickly towards the enemy base. TA's Ags, it just casts faster now, which is nice. Means you can use it reflexively more. Terrorblade is back in the meta. His Ags, instead of activating when he ults, is now its own ability with its own cooldown, meaning he fears when he needs it, not automatically on meta. Movement speed buff. All his talents got buffed. The movement speed, the evasion, the health, the attack speed, reflection cooldown. He's just a better hero. Tide Hunter got a base strength increase of 3, which also affects his damage, meaning that his Anchor Smash, I hate it, I hate it, I hate it, I hate it. Tinker. Cast range talent it got increased, making him bull. Absolutely bullshit. March of Machines duration increased. That's not that big of a deal. I wouldn't take it most of the time. Tiny attack backswing was reduced, making him attack a little faster. Tree Ant Nature's Guise region amplification for himself. I think it's himself, right? Yeah. He heals better when he's invis. That's all. Tusk is faster. Shards does more damage at all levels, making him a much... He's already a good hero, but a much better hero. That's so big. Tombstone Zombies got a 10 damage buff, which is actually really big. Ursa, second broken hero. Ready? Fury Swipe's damage was increased dramatically. In a single overpower, Ursa does 250 more damage just from Fury Swipes alone. 250 than it did. Meaning, like, just comparing this 28 at level 4 to the 40. Just that. Overpower attack count was reduced by 1. That's okay, because I was only comparing it on 6 attacks, not the 7. Cooldown was reduced, though, at later levels, which is nice. Mana cost was reduced as well at earlier levels, and it doesn't even scale to be as much, so that's pretty bull. Here's the meat of it. Enrage no longer has a Fury Swipes multiplier, so he does do less damage when he ults. However, the damage is barely anything. Me and Zeratov were figuring it out, and Zeratov said the increase to his damage on Fury Swipes is almost as if he was ulting at the old level 1 always. Would you rather do as much damage as Ursa's level 1 ult before all of the time and not be able to scale higher, or scale higher the way it used to be? I would say all of the time. Enrage duration was increased, so it lasts longer. It still gives you the damage reduction as well. Its cooldown was reduced, so it's up more often at that earlier level. and it now grants 50% status resistance base with no ability, no talent or anything. Now the talent that gives status resistance is now extra overpower attacks, because that's cool. Broken. Magic missile casts farther but does less damage. It's a nice buff though, I like that. Actually does more damage later too, so it's fine. Viper Strike's damage went up. I'm sure Aphra was happy. And his spell lifesteal talent went up too, making it a much better talent. I would actually consider taking it out. Visage. Base attack speed went up. I hate Visage. Soul Assumption collection radius was increased, meaning he doesn't have to be that close. And the cast range on Soul Assumption was increased, meaning he can shoot you from a mile away. Instead of just negative 2 Gravekeeper Cloak, 2 seconds to restack it, it instead adds 6 Gravekeeper's Cloak stacks, which should actually just make Visage immortal. Scepter for Void Spirit. Resonant Pulse is now a charge-based ability with 2 charges, and it silences enemies for 2 seconds. Shoot me. I don't... he's still terrible late game. He turns more into, like, a utility hero, initiation hero, which is still good, mind you. But, like, I just don't want this. No thank you. Shadow Words cast point was improved by 0.1, making it cast faster. The talents around it got better as well. Weaver. Base int increased. Int gain increased. Base mana regen increased, meaning Weaver always has more mana. Shikuchi. Instead of giving you a static amount of movement speed, which is pretty large, it now gives a little bit less at level 1 and then immediately gives you more movement speed for the rest of the game. Can you see the difference? Like, this is crazy. 55 more movement speed when he has level 4 Shikuchi. He moves so fast. Windranger. Intelligence gain increased by 0.6, making her do a lot more damage. Even with the nerf to Javelin. Cold Embrace, now considered a heal instead of regen, changing the way that some things around it work, not a big deal. Paralyzing Cast mana cost was reduced, making Witch Doctor a better character. Death Ward Scepter no longer has a bounce limit, so you can hit the entire team if there's meepos or whatever in there. Wraith King's Aura is worse for his team, but he gets more, and apparently his damage also goes up. I don't really get it. Oh, right, because it gives everybody bonus damage, right? So he gets extra damage on top of that. So Wraith King will do more damage now when he has his passive. But everybody else will get less lifesteal. Zeus is a little faster and has a better attack point, meaning he can actually get less hits in lane, a little. All right, that's the end of the patch. I think the bigger things are some of these heroes that need to be nerfed. I'm going to go to demo one hero because I have not seen yet how fast Weaver is. I got to know. It seems important, doesn't it, Thorpe?
Yeah, pretty much, considering he can just, like, probably run across the map pretty much.
Probably.
I wouldn't be surprised.
I actually want to test Jug, too, to see if he does purge.
Weaver.
I'm gonna level... Is there a talent for it, too? Yeah, there is.
Okay, see that big tree thing? I see more of the...
Ready? Oh, I don't have boots. Because I forgot. Okay, so I should have, you know, whatever.
Yes.
He's pretty fast. Alright, and now, since the talent is a static amount, meaning it's not percentage-based, he'll go even faster when he hits 25, because I'm assuming he'll take the out of 25 now. Look how fast he is. Oh my god. I can't even!
Wait, do it again. Let me see the power.
Are you looking?
Yeah, I'm looking.
Yes.
Oh, fun.
He's not dying yet.
And remember this. Weaver sometimes buys agility items, right? So those will increase his speed if he has, like, a butterfly. Or, like, a Scotty. I don't know why he builds Scotty, but that'll be okay. All right, because now he has the agility that benefits the speed, too. 940 movement speed. 940 movement speed. It's so stupid. I hate this game, dude.
Just counter him with Bloodseeker.
Oh, if you get a Hurricane Pike, which he does get sometimes, 948. No, he's faster than the Bloodseeker. Bloodseeker will not move as fast as Weaver. Weaver will just leave.
No, but I meant with the
Alt. Oh, yeah.
He just runs himself to death and immediately melts.
Imagine how far away you can go with time lapse, by the way.
Oh, God. You should try that out and see.
That's crazy. All right, hold on. The only other hero I have to is Jug. Jug, jug, jug.
You should see how far you can get before time lapse will put you back across to the other side of the map.
Okay. So, I need an enemy hero who will actually debuff me. Axe can do it, actually, because usually when they do... okay. So I'll give him Battle Hunger. I'll buy an Agonis. Unfortunately, I have to level him to max 2, though.
Wow. That's a pretty big distance, actually.
It's stupid. All right. So Agonims. So I'm going to Battle Hunger myself. Oh, yeah. It purges. Battle Hunger just left.
Wow. So your mini Omni Slash just lets you go now?
Yep. I thought so. I haven't tried That's this yet. I don't good. Think it lasts long enough, but I want to see if I can Mask of Madness while doing it. Yep, you can. I mean, it's not worth it because it's only you get about 3 hits, even with the mask. But
fine idea.
I do wonder
though.
That's
pretty
cool. Drag off and buy
some ants. I'm guessing
Mansa,
crits affect that
butterfly.
Stuff too.
Butterfly.
I'm gonna jug you and buy now, Bissell. Why not? I got 4 hits. Being level 30 and having a pretty generic amount of items, I got 4 hits. Yeah, I think 4 hits is probably the most you'll ever get off of it, unfortunately. But the thing I've been doing to everybody else who's watching, basically what I do is I start a fight, like I'm trying to get in, get out. I'll throw this on and try to bait out some of the bigger abilities. I didn't mean to do that. That was an accident. Oops. What I've been doing is I've been trying to go in, spin, do what you gotta do with people around, try to disarm someone, whatever. More enemies come in, and then I'll really ult. I forgot to the Mask of Madness when I did that, by the way.
Innocent lives taken.
I never used to know you could Mask of Madness, by the way, during ult. It's crazy, though. There's so much damage. Except when I don't bounce the axe I'm in to bounce to. In that case, it's not.
Again, I have to ask. Crits to be effective.
Crits? What do you mean?
You get crits on people, right?
When you're Omni Slashing? Of course. Everything procs. You can use anything you want during Omni Slash too. Like, I knew you could blink. I don't know why.
I had a brain fart. Let's pretend that I'm not mentally challenged. I forgot you had a built-in crit for some reason.
Yes. Yes, you do. All right, I'm going to end this stream. I'm about to start playing Dota for real, so everybody on Twitch just hold on 2 minutes. But I like to separate these videos because people do like to see the patches by themselves and not have the gameplay overlap it. So, for those of you on YouTube, I appreciate you for